Namaste, welcome to my home kitchen. I'm Bhavna and today I'm making requested recipe of Surti Locho. Favorite breakfast for workers. So let's start making Surti Locho. To make this Surti Locho, take 1.5 cups of chana dal, the Bengal gram, and 1/2 cup of urad dal, black gram. Soak overnight or at least 5 to 6 hours, and I also add beaten rice, poha. So I take 1/2 cup of poha. Poha you do not need to soak overnight, just soak 1/2 hour before you are ready to make this locho. So here I have the dals soaked last night, and this poha I soaked this morning. Now I'm going to blend all these ingredients into the blender. Here is the soaked chana dal, urad dal, and poha, beaten rice. Here I have my blender, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to drain out the water and reserve on a side right now, so that if I need, when I blend, I can use this water. And first thing I'm going to add is the chana dal. So add the dal and blend to smooth puree. Add a little bit more water if you have a hard time blending. Alright, so I'm done with the chana dal, and I'm going to take out into this bowl here. So take out the prepared dal. You can see that the texture is a coarse texture, and this is how we want, that's perfect. And now the urad dal. So the urad dal is also done. Now with the urad dal, I'm going to add this poha, beaten rice. Because it's a liquidy right now, so I don't have to add additional water. So that's perfect for me. So I can just add with urad dal and blend again. So this urad dal is also done with the poha. So I'm going to take out this into this bowl here as well. So take out the urad dal and ground urad dal in the poha. And now mix very well. Now before I add spices and some other ingredients into this prepared mixture, I'm going to prepare my steamer. In this steamer, I'm going to take enough water and I have this tray. It doesn't have to be similar steamer like mine. You can steam in any kind of steamer that you have. Now into this tray, I'm going to spread a little bit of oil. So grease this tray with the oil. And I'm also going to preheat this tray as well. So while this is, while the water is boiling, I keep this tray into this steamer. Now unlike other recipes, Gujarati recipes like dokla, khaman, this batter does not need fermentation, so make sure that you do not allow it to ferment. And I'm going to cover this steamer and let the water come to the boil. And into this batter I'm going to add oil, turmeric powder, green chili paste, and some other ingredients. I also have the Eno here. Eno allows to rise this locho very well. So a couple of tablespoons of oil. From my 4G box, I'm going to add green chili paste. Adjust your taste. Just a little bit of ginger paste, optional. Usually, traditionally, ginger is not added, but I kind of like to add. Pinch of turmeric powder. Salt, adjust your taste. And now, mix very well. Do not add Eno yet. Add Eno at the very last moment. So basically, this mixture is ready, and I'm going to wait till my steamer is done. Now I can hear that the water is coming to the boil. So at this point I'm going to add about 1.5 teaspoon of Eno and give it a good stir now, and it will get very light, fluffy batter. You can see that it rises instantly. I can see even the bubbles in this batter. And now carefully open this steamer, and I'm going to pour this batter into this steamer, and I'm going to pour this batter. Alright, make it even. Now on the top I'm going to sprinkle ground black pepper, calamari. So freshly ground black pepper. If you wish, you can also sprinkle red chili powder. I'm using paprika because I've already added enough green chili into my batter. So that's just perfect. Cover it. And I'm going to steam about 15 minutes. But you can check if the inserted toothpick comes out clear, then it's done. Make sure to steam on a high heat. This locho has been steaming for about 15 minutes now, so I'm going to check on it. So carefully open it because the steam coming out of the steamer, so be very careful. Oh my gosh, look at that. It has risen nice even. Look at the bumpy in the center. And I'm going to insert the knife in the center. And look at this, it came out clear. It took about 16 to 18 minutes for mine because I had a thick layer of batter. So it depends even how thick your locho is. So you have to steam according to that. Now there's a special way of serving this locho. If you want to keep this hot, then you can wrap into the foil. You can take the big aluminum foil and wrap this locho into the aluminum foil to keep it warm. Now I'm going to show you how you can serve. So I'm going to take a little amount of locho from this tray. Using the plastic butter knife, run on the edges. Very soft, spongy, it already looks like. And I'm going to take the big piece of this locho. Now using the spatula, I'm going to take that big piece of locho, and you can see that steam coming out of it, and you can just break like this. This locho is always eaten hot right from the steamer, and now it's time to season it up. To season up this locho, here I have the fresh lemon, fresh finely chopped cilantro, finely chopped onion, fine sage. Here I have some green chilies. And also the oil is poured on the top. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pour the oil. Squeeze the lemon, make sure that the seeds doesn't get into the locho. Right, just like that. Onion. Sprinkle some sage on the top. Finely chopped cilantro, dania. And here I have this green chili, and this plate is ready. And look at this plate, I'm ready to give it a bite. The word locho means lumpy. So this is basically a lumpy savory cake. And few onion, cilantro, sage, and ready to get into the mouth. Once you make, then you will know only why Sooty people are crazy about this Sooty locho. It does taste really great and goes very well with the tea or just it itself, and you will sure love this recipe. So this was all about Sooty locho. Thank you for watching, and I will see you real soon with the next great recipe.
And look at this, the steam also coming out of it.